the show, we introduce you to Talia, the 13-year-old makeup artist who is battling two forms of cancer. How do you stay so positive?
When people ask me that, I'm just, what do you want me to do? Be depressed? Mm-hmm. I mean, but a little fishy told me, just keep swimming, just keep swimming.
All the chemicals inside, I wanna feel. I wanna sunburn, just to know that I'm alive, to know I'm alive. Don't tell me if I'm dying, 'cause I don't wanna know. Tell me if I'm dying, 'cause I don't wanna know if I can't see the sun.
Took an x-ray, and there it was. My tumor was right here in my abdomen. It was scary. I mean, all the doctors, they had to kind of hold me down. That they had to do a blood test, and it was scary, very scary. I asked the doctor, am I going to lose my hair? And he looked at my mom looked at me. She nodded, and I started to cry.
Hey, everyone. So, Yeah. Okay, this first thing I got is I'm like shaking. I'm always shaking because okay, don't make fun of me. Okay. My nose itches.
I used to lay in bed and I would close my eyes and just imagine my little tumor shrinking to nothing. Just imagine that x-ray, that CAT scan, the MRI, the MIBG. Just look at it and poof, it's gone. My mom's friend used to tell me that God or whatever you believe in, Jesus, Buddha? I don't know. What else is there? God, no God, higher power, anything. In my case, God. My mom's friend used to say that God loves children and he'll listen to you. So just squeeze your hands as hard as you can. And I know this is weird, but don't laugh at me. I talk into my hands and I say my prayer. I tell God about my day and I ask him for help. Or I ask him to just soothe me and just be calm. And then I put a kiss, and I let it out. And then I wiggle my hands because I feel like I should. Just don't lose hope. Go buy makeup. Don't lose hope. Pray every night. Don't lose faith. Yeah. Sorry about that. I kind of teared up. But you have a really, really, really fascinating life ahead of you, and you have dreams and wishes to accomplish and just many good things to come your way. Remember, don't lose hope. Don't do anything besides have hope. Imagine yourself older, long hair, you have kids, cancer-free. I was diagnosed with cancer when I was 7. And the doctor said that I had 3 months to live if we didn't catch it. And 5 years, I'm still doing it. Hi everyone, so today I'm doing my May favorites. I'm finally not like 4 months late. Like, I'm so excited. Holy crap, it is summer, and really quickly, I'm in a long sleeve and a scarf. One, because it's very mucky outside, and I don't like that feeling on my skin. And second, it's kind of cold out, like, in Florida right now. First of all, it just stormed, so yeah. That's why I'm kind of like this, not the summer feel, but it's cute. It's like, has summer colors, yeah, fun, right? Okay. This one is probably the most serious one. I know I had bad news about my cancer spreaded to my bone marrow, which, yes. We still haven't done any treatment, but my actual bone marrow that I did, like the bone marrow test, the final results came back, and I also have pre-leukemia in my bone marrow. So basically, right now, I have two types of cancer in my body. The pre-leukemia is not fully developed, but it's pre-leukemia, which means eventually it will be leukemia. And there's nothing really out there that treats both type of cancers. They're both very, very serious and very, very aggressive cancers, and they spread very quickly, and they're both very, very deadly. Now, we'll put it that way, and I'm being straight up about that. And I've been doing this crap for over 5 years. Basically, there's not really a lot of options for treatment anymore. I'm going to decide whether or not I want to do the bone marrow transplant, or whether or not I just want to don't do it and just live the time that I have remaining. The doctor said if we didn't go through with it, they said 4 months to a year,
And if you're younger than 12, I don't know if you would comprehend what I'm saying. The chances of surviving are fewer than surviving. So, yeah, and also if we even find a match for my bone marrow, if my body rejects it, then I'm screwed. Everyone asks me if I'm scared. I'm definitely scared. This is not fair to me anymore. I'm only 13. I shouldn't really have to be doing this. No one should have to do this, not even adults. And it's really not fair for kids to have cancer, and it's really freaking suck. It sucks freaking so badly. I know I kind of sound like, I don't know, it's just, it's hard to explain. I'm gonna continue doing videos as long as I can, and I just wanted you guys to know that because I really, really want the whole world to know what's going on with me, and it's not really gonna be a secret, and I really, really, really love doing YouTube, and you guys are freaking amazing. Like, I really, really hope that you guys are just don't freak out. Is what I tell a lot of my friends. It's not like it's gonna be tomorrow. It's just, yeah, it's just a quality of life, and it's not, nothing's for sure. We still don't know if there's any other options besides this huge transplant thing. I really, really, really hope you guys, like, understand what I'm saying and understand where I'm coming from. I'll continue making videos, but, yeah. I love you guys so, so much. My birthday is on the 18th. We're having a huge party. I'm going to vlog it, hopefully. And, yeah. That's, yeah. So.